At 6 a.m. on July 4th, 2012, Farida Afridi was intercepted by two motorcyclists, who pulled out guns and shot her as she was leaving her home to go to work. She was hit 5 times in the head and chest. To date, no one has been caught or punished for her murder. 3 years earlier, Afridi, along with her sister Nurzia and Laljan Afridi, had created Sawera, or the Society for Appraisal and Women Empowerment in Rural Areas. She gave lectures and provided information on women's rights.
Reforms ko takriban pa har shoba ke pakar di che wishi o especially focus ki khaze o jina ke.
Sawera works to protect women and girls' human rights and promote their empowerment in some of the most dangerous and conservative parts of the country. Approximately 3 million girls are not in school in Pakistan, often prevented from attending by conservative families who see no value in educating their daughters. In the tribal areas where Sawera works, as many as 92% of girls and women are illiterate, and many are married off at young ages and left to a virtual life of domestic imprisonment. Violence against girls and women is rampant, with thousands of reported cases of domestic violence, rapes, and murders each year, which is only remarkable in that there are surely thousands more that go unreported. In this extremely dangerous environment, Sawera provides basic capacity building services, microfinance and livelihood opportunities, and rights awareness programs. Beyond protecting individuals, the impact of Sawera's work is aimed at transforming society. Girls' education and women's employment and development opportunities are well documented to have vast socioeconomic implications for any society. And in Pakistan, especially in the lawless tribal areas, Sawera fills a devastating void. To carry out its program, Sawera staff members go into local communities and meet with local tribal leaders to persuade them to allow women and girls to participate. While simply traveling to many of these villages is risky enough, the project Sawera proposes to carry out challenges long-standing norms and what is perceived to be tribal culture. Despite a multitude of constraints, psychological, cultural, economic, material, Sawera manages to help hundreds of women and girls and their families. The threats are constant and real. Almost exactly 1 year ago, on March 30th, 2013, the Sawera office was bombed, destroying virtually everything in the office. Yet the organization and its staff persist, with an uncommon fortitude, resilience, and courage. According to Nurzia Afridi, "I will never leave this job because it's the mission of my sister, and God willing, I will complete it."
"It's a matter of great joy to me that God chosen us to deliver this service to humanity. I hope the day is no longer ahead, too far distant, when the poor of our communities will be able to exercise and enjoy their basic human rights. They dream for their rights. We are their hope, and hope always forces you to survive. We have tried to initiate many projects for them to protect the rights of internally displaced persons, IDPs, to enable women to live with dignity. We have initiated peace activities involving women and children to help restore a durable peace in the tribal region. We provide cultural exchange programs. We provide relief to women. Although Sawera does not want to depend on dependency, but rather to help women to adopt practices that will enable them to earn money, especially those women living in extreme poverty or who have been affected by disaster. In the past, Sawera has been targeted. Our beloved colleague was shot, and besides the bombing of our office, we are still committed and we have still lost our courage. If they kill one, a million will arise."
Help protect human rights defenders on the front line. Contribute at www.frontlinedefenders.org/donate. Thank you.